Good evening. First tonight, a hoarder is being blamed for a ferocious fire that has gutted his Malvern East home and threatened neighbouring properties. Locals have described the home as an accident waiting to happen. 10's Jade Vincent is at the scene and joins us live now. Jade, a busy day for fire crews.
That's right, Mal. Neighbours here say that the owner is a known hoarder and they'd made several complaints to council about the serious fire risk of his home. Now, sadly, that concern became a reality today. Just before 2:30 this afternoon, the home went up in flames. It was consumed by big plumes of smoke and as firefighters worked for over an hour to get it under control and stop it spreading to nearby properties. We spoke to the owner earlier today who admits he is a hoarder in remission and was clearing out the house at the time the fire started, but unfortunately his home has been completely destroyed and he wasn't insured.
I think it's a strong sun.
How would that cause the fire?
The sun could have been concentrated by a bottle perhaps. Or a mirror, perhaps?
It's something we've been waiting to happen for a long time. We've been on to the council, we've been trying to do something about it. You know, I feel sorry for Julian, but he's a compulsive collector and his house is filled with rubbish.
Now, it's also been a busy afternoon for firefighters in Werribee, and that's where we cross live now to 10's Yasmin Payton.
Thank you, Jade. One man is in hospital after a fire broke out this afternoon here in Werribee. It's believed the man who lived at the unit may have been trying to decant fuel from his car inside the garage. Now, that's caused an explosion and the garage has caught alight. The man suffered facial and internal burns, but paramedics say he was actually very lucky. If he'd had the garage door closed at the time, they say he may well have been killed by the blast. At the time the fire broke out, it was 36 degrees. And that's made for very challenging conditions for firefighters. Four of them have been treated for heat exhaustion by paramedics this afternoon. I spoke to one of them a short time ago.
Well, it's very dangerous. Obviously, you've got things going pop and bang, and obviously the fire is obviously something we're trying to focus on getting out as quickly as we can.
Fire investigators are on the scene at the moment to confirm what caused the blaze as the man recovers in hospital.
Reporting live there on the two fires, Jade Vincent and Yasmin Payton.